How many of you have never been, let's take a commercial break for just a second. How many of you have never been to a place called Genghis Grill? You've never been to Genghis Grill. Never been. Good majority. All right, you can put your hands down. How many of you have been to Genghis Grill? Would you raise your hand, testify? So obviously you and I are in the minority. I do not have an NIL deal with Genghis Grill. I get no kickbacks on this. And if you work at Genghis Grill, you're welcome. All right, so... But if you've ever been to Genghis Grill, you have to understand the process. There's a buffet bar of meats, vegetables, sauces, and spices. You sit down, identify who your waiter or waitress is, you order your beverage, and then you have a choice to make in regards to the size of the bowl. You go, Ed, what's the size of the bowl? Small, medium, large, stainless steel bowl. And you go put as much as you can, that price that you've been given is the size of the bowl. It does not tell you that you cannot stack up in the bowl as high as possible. It gives no regulations, no specifications, no rules and don'ts. It just gives, they give you a bowl. That's what they give you, a bowl. Now, my children, we have four children, they will order a bigger size than what they actually need because they will get a big bowl and waste the bowl. See, you can put as much as you want in the bowl and they'll halfway fill the bowl. But I get a smaller size, and I'll tell you why I get a smaller size, because one, I'm paying for their meal. They think they got money, but they ain't got no money, all right? And they ordering like they got money. So I got to downsize so they get upsize. Come on, radical generosity, just radical generosity. But what I've learned at Genghis Grill is when you go down the buffet bar of meats and vegetables and spices and sauces, you begin with the meat, and so I get a small size, and I take the tongs, and I take the tongs, and I begin to get the chicken and the fish and the meat, and I put it in the bowl. But I don't just put it in the bowl and move on. Oh, come on, somebody. I'm preaching today. I take those tongs because I have paid attention to Tetris growing up, and I take those tongs, and I start pressing down the meat. Back and forth, side to side, evenly distributing the meat and mashing it down all together. Making room for the vegetables. So then I move to the vegetables, and then I begin to put the snow peas and the broccoli and all the other green and orange assorted items into that space. And then all of a sudden, guess what I do? I take that same bowl, I put the tongs down, and I begin to shake it, which allows it to fall into place. And then I realize that there's still room in the bowl. So I go back to the meat. Come on, holler if you hear me today. I go back to the meat. And I put the meat on top of the vegetables, and I get those tongs, and I start pressing again. And I still got some room, so I'll go back to the vegetables, and I'll put more vegetables. And so it's meat, vegetables, special patties, sauce, lettuce, cheese. Anyway, so in the process of that, it's all stacked up, and then I begin to shake it a little bit more, and then I add a little bit more, so it's just layer upon layer upon layer, and then I find myself putting the bowl up against my chest. Oh, don't judge me. Don't judge it. I put it up against my chest, because here's the deal. All I got to do is get that bowl to the counter, and then it goes to the chef. They don't weigh it. They don't measure it. They didn't go, hey, listen, you got the size of a big bowl, but you got a little bowl. They don't say anything. It's judgment-free, and that's you just got to get it to the counter. So I'm walking so carefully and so slowly to get it to that moment. And when I set it down, I'm like, God bless you. Thank you so much. This is where you pick this up, and you got to get everything. And then they cook it and then give it to you. And when it comes out, watch this, it is overflowing. And my kids are like, Dad, your bowl was smaller than our bowl. And I'll go, but yeah, you wasted all that space. Why am I telling you this? Because when the Bible says, oh, church, get with me, press down. Come on, church. Shaken together, running over, put it into your lap. You go, Ed, when does God do this? This is the priority of receiving. So when you choose to live in a spirit of generosity in all five categories, five capitals of your life, financial, relational, intellectual, physical, and spiritual, guess what happens? God goes, you're a prime candidate for my blessing. But when I deliver my blessing to you, come on, church, get with me, not only in this room, overflow and watching online. God goes, before I give you the blessing, I got a bowl and I'm pressing it down because I want to give you as much blessing as possible. I press it down. I shake it out. I stack it up. And watch this. And God walks to you with the blessing and goes, here we go. God bless you. And guess what? And in the process of receiving the blessing, you go, oh, it's overflowing. But when you recognize that it gives you the abundance and the overflow, because it's not really just about you, it's about blessing those around you, then he has found somebody that he could pour out blessing on that's not an owner of anything, but a steward of everything. Because most people live their life because hustle is muscle. What you'll do is you'll try to get to gain with a grasp of its mind. But here's what you fail to recognize is if you live your whole life to get something and wrap your fingers around it and clutch it in your fist, then you can't let God bless a closed fist. But when you take the blessings of God and go, God, it's all yours, then God goes, yeah, you can have that, but let me give you some other stuff too. Because when you choose to live that way, God goes, I'm looking for somebody to bless so they'll be a blessing. Come on, church, can we clap to that today? Would that be all right? I'm looking for somebody to bless so they could be a blessing. Oh, you thought we were talking about money. We're talking about so much more. Your life and the offering plate.